Friends, here is a demo on the usage of Vibrochek, a digital biothesiometer. Vibrochek is brought to you by Proactive, a leading healthcare device company. Vibrochek can be called an electronic tuning fork that checks the level of neuropathy in a patient: normal, mild, moderate, and severe. As you know, neuropathy is one of the most commonly occurring disorders due to idiopathic causes or due to some genetic disorders, metabolic or endocrine disorders, etc. Vibrochek is especially helpful in checking diabetic peripheral neuropathy. Let us begin the demonstration. How to operate Vibrochek? Vibrochek has two parts: the main machine and probe with a handle. 1. Connect the power cable to the mains. 2. Plug in the handle cable into the main machine. The probe is now charged. 3. Switch on the unit. 10V will appear on the screen. Testing preparation. Enable the patient to lie down in a supine position. Explain that you will be testing vibration sensation in their feet at various points, and they will be sensing each vibration. Now apply the probe located under the handle to the patient's hand and let the patient feel the vibrations clearly by keeping the threshold point at V4 or V5. This will acclimatize the patient to the sensation. Brief them to respond loudly by feeling the sensation and then stating yes or no loudly. 4. A check button provided on the handle creates a placebo situation. Press this off and on so that you can verify the patient's correct response to the sensation. Please note, Vibrochek has 5 vibration perception threshold points: V1 to V5, which gives continuous vibrations as per the tuning fork frequencies; V1, 10 volts; V2, 13 volts; V3, 19 volts; V4, 25 volts; V5, 31 volts. How to test? 1. Keep the patient's demographics leaflet for ready reference. 2. Place the probe on each feet point in a sequential manner, as indicated on the patient's demographic report. Start from the right foot from number 1. Carry out the test on each point at least twice to ensure consistency. There are a total of 9 points where sensations have to be checked. 3. Start checking with 10 volts, V1. If patient does not feel any sensation, then increase the vibration by turning control switch clockwise to 13 volts, V2. Cross-check patient using the check button to gauge the correct response. 4. Screen all the points on the feet as mentioned in the leaflet. Reporting. Jot down the response volts in the patient demographic VPT report on designated points. For example, right leg 13.1, 13.2, 13.3, 10.4, etc. Left leg 13.1, 10.2, 13.3, 13.4, etc. Fill up all the volts in the blanks given. Now total up the figures of the right foot. Arrive at the average. Total up the figures of the left foot. Arrive at the average. Compute the average of both right foot and left foot. This is the final average to be considered for the patient. Interpretation. derive the interpretation from the final average as below. Up to 40 years, up to 10 volts, normal. Between 13 and 19 volts, mild neuropathy, mild loss of sensation. Between 19 and 25 volts, moderate neuropathy, moderate loss of sensation. Above 25 volts, severe neuropathy, severe loss of sensation, very abnormal. Above 40 years, up to 13 volts, normal. Between 13 and 19 volts, mild neuropathy, mild loss of sensation. Between 19 and 25 volts, moderate neuropathy, moderate loss of sensation. Above 25 volts, severe neuropathy, severe loss of sensation, very abnormal. Inform the patient that the report has to be brought back at the time of the next visit.
Hello, I am Dr. Bansi Sabu, diabetologist at Ahmedabad. What I found is a vibration perception threshold, a VPT meter, is really very useful in our day-to-day clinical practice. I recommend all clinicians, all physicians who are interested in practice of diabetes for diabetic neuropathy checking, screening, for mass screening program, and patients for prognosis also to use regularly in their day-to-day practice. Thank you.